What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome to another episode of Go GTS Live, the hobby's first and most watched live streaming web show in the hobby. Woohoo! Thanks for joining us tonight, man. We got a great show planned for you tonight. I'm your host, Rob Bertrand, that guy over there in the awesome Signatures for Soldiers shirt, Ivan Lovgren. Ivan, what's going on, dude?
Oh, man. So much going on in the hobby today, starting off with an incredible poll question that I am ready to debate with you. Yeah, things are good. The weather's hot. So hot, there's no background today. I hope you're okay seeing what life is actually like over here in the 90210. But shout out to everybody in the chat on Twitch, on live stream, on YouTube. And also, Rob, you know what I found out this past week?
No.
What? I didn't even know that this show gets put out as a podcast after the fact as well. So
you didn't know
you
that?
You can listen to this on various podcast networks. I don't know. Do I look like I understand a thing about how computers work?
Oh, shout out to our Facebook viewers as well. Oh, and our Periscope viewers. Wait a minute. Scratch that. Apparently, we're still banned from Periscope. And at this point, we don't even really know why. So,
yeah. Can't all be my fault at this point.
We're going to stick with that theory that it's Ivan's fault, and he's going to follow up with them since I didn't get a reply and see if maybe we tackle this from two angles and get some answers. But anyway,
exactly.
Yeah, we've got a great show planned for you tonight. There's a lot to talk about in hobby happenings. We have three fantastic box breaks, including the first 2021 NHL Hockey Product of the Year. We've got an off the post with last year's NHL Rookie of the Year. We've got a look at next week's new sports card releases and a video from a news report out of Detroit about the booming sports card market, all that and much more. But first and foremost, we do kick off things, as always, with our Go GTS Live Q of the Week poll.
Ooh, and it's hot.
It is hot.
It's hot. I want to see debate. I want to see argument.
And first and foremost, the question as phrase clearly refers to which baseball player. So anybody who answered with a basketball player, I don't know what you were thinking. Mantle, Wagner, Trout are the only baseball players to have cards sell for more than $1 million. Which player will be next? And some people are probably curious as to our selections, as to why we chose these. Eddie Plank.
I know 98.1% are definitely confused about one choice. Okay. That's for sure.
Eddie Plank and Sherry Maggie, their T206 cards respectively. Babe Ruth or Joe Jackson. Nolan Ryan or Pete Rose. And the note being that all of those listed players have had recent card sales between $600 and $700,000+. So that's like your next level when you're looking at the highest price paid for cards. You know, it goes Trout, Wagner, Mantle, and then these guys. So we want to know of those, or maybe it's you think it'll be a current player, of those, which is going to be the next $1 million man?
So before we jump into the debate, if you can't tell from the screenshot, make sure right now that you go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive and vote. Because we mentioned the product that we're opening today, it's going to be an incredible product giveaway day. You have to be following and engaging on Twitter to do that. So we set it up with the poll engagement so that you get involved there. So do that. And now let's debate.
All right. So I'll let you have first crack at it, Ivan.
Well, I don't know if you saw my response, Rob, but I did respond from my personal hobby Twitter at Watch the Breaks. And I said, trick question, Michael Jordan. Because, yeah, I caught what you said. I caught that you did say the only baseball players or the next baseball player. But come on, two seasons with the Birmingham Barons and spring training with the White Sox. Booyah, baseball player.
Oh, done. You're so clever. All right, now let's have a real conversation. Which player, legitimate baseball player and their card? Not a specific card, mind you. Who do you think will be the next million-dollar guy?
Well, I would like, actually, if you could dive into a little bit of the context, because Eddie Plank and Sherry Maggie are going, they're so far behind everything else.
And yet they're the number three or number four and five on the list, I believe.
Yeah, like where did those come? When did those prices happen? I don't even remember seeing that. Like, fill me in a bit.
All right. I will
called on the encyclopedia.
I will get
to see Rob Google during the show.
I will tell you. Okay, here's the deal. The Sherry Maggie is an error card. Okay.
Pop report.
They spelled his name wrong. It does have to do with the pop report. But so T206 people are crazy. They're absolutely crazy. So yes. The third or fourth on the list is the 1915-16 Sporting News Babe Ruth baseball card. So sold for like $717,000. But
so Babe Ruth is actually next in line.
That's what I voted for. I think it would surprise a lot of people that Babe Ruth hasn't had a million-dollar baseball card to date yet, and he hasn't.
I forget which auction house had it, but at last year's National, there was a beautiful Gaudi Babe Ruth. It was a was it a 10 from 1933?
So. Yeah, remember
and
that?
And I remember being shocked that it only sold for I can't even remember, but I remember thinking it'd go for 200,000 more than it ended at. What's up with that? What's up with Mantle getting so much more love than Babe Ruth?
Don't you think there's just so much prestige and, I don't know, not mystery.
They were both drunks.
So, okay.
Well, let me fill you in a little bit, because I know that I can't expect you to Google everything during the show. So PSA, people forget the PSA does have a section of their site called Card Facts. So if you ever do want to learn a little bit about history, like there's a great page on the Sherry Maggie card. Now, they do say it is also they claim it's perhaps the most famous error card in the entire hobby. I would argue that's not true because I've been in the hobby for 30 years and this is the first time hearing of it. Maybe it's the highest end one.
Or one of the first.
Yeah, or one of the first. But come on, everybody knows the Frank Thomas. My buddies that haven't collected know the Frank Thomas no name on front. So I don't think we can call it that. But yes, they misspelled his name, and it's considered one of the three big rarities in the T206 set.
Now, here's the thing. When you look at the list of the most expensive baseball cards ever sold, Mickey Mantle has two. But I didn't want to go for specific card because I think the next card will go for $1 million or more is the 1951 Bowman Mickey Mantle. Okay. That's number four on the list. Number five on the list is, excuse me, this.
Fernando Tatis Jr.
But guess what? Guess who's right after that at number six? Pete Rose rookie card. $717,000.
I have to imagine.
Then Eddie Plank.
You said Pete Rose rookie. That's
then tops, Joe Jackson's Carmel
tops
card.
Tops rookie, right.
And then the Sherry Maggie air card.
Now, is that – so I'm on the PSA website right now trying
to
find
it. Yeah, the Floating Heads, 1963.
Oh, so it's pop one. That's crazy.
It was a 10.
Interesting.
It was a 10.
So population reports play into it. Remember, I've talked about this quite a bit this year. Ricky Henderson's Topps rookie pop 10 is like a six-figure card, even though it's from 1980, which feels pretty recent for a lot of us, right?
But that's why when I'm sure there were some people that went Pete Rose, that card sold in 2016. For $717,000. If that same card, Pop 1, Gem Mint 10, PSA, came to market today, That's you want to know something crazy? Card, right?
So, because of the fact that I'm not good at multitasking, I accidentally clicked on 1964 Tops, which is Pete Rose's individual all-star rookie. Zero tens in population.
Wow.
So, if you see one of those in the wild,
Yeah, so I want to backtrack what I said about... I know. I wanted to backtrack just a little bit about my where I put Plank and Maggie in the order. They're in there, but they are not as high as I originally had them because I kept forgetting that Rose had that card, $717,000.
Well, so we could talk on all day about this, but I do want to hit up some of the viewer comments from Twitch. Alex Kent mentioning, what about the Jackie Robinson 1948 rookie? Interesting. Do you have a comp on that off the back of your
head? I know it doesn't even make the top 10.
Okay. Ice Blue Texas with Reggie Jackson Orioles Tops rookie.
Not even close.
Okay. And then going to the Twitter to get some actual responses on Twitter. Luka Doncic doesn't count. I did answer other or current player with my trick question, Michael Jordan. I wouldn't be surprised, however, if you saw recently, I believe it was a Luis Robert numbered to 5 refractor, or was it Tatis? Fernando Tatis numbered to 5 refractor, already cracked the 6 figures at auction.
Wow. That's awesome.
So with the modern craze and the created scarcity, I could see a player hitting that. And I will also add, based on the number of basketball responses, that maybe we should run the same poll next week with basketball, or run it on an off day with basketball and just sort of cover it. I don't know. We have a busy show next week too, so probably can't run two polls.
Whoever said the 1948 Jackie Robinson leaf is a very good suggestion, but you know whose card from that set actually has sold for over $400,000? Satchel Paige. Yeah. So
I like that. So yeah, so let's run that with basketball next week. What do you think?
Yeah. So some of these prices might have switched. The most recent, most comprehensive listing I could find was published on March 6th of this year on stadiumtalk.com, and the article title is Most Expensive Baseball Cards Ever Sold. So there might be some tweaking of those cards, but as of right now, I can't wait to see who the next million-dollar guy is. And I agree. If it's not Babe Ruth, it very well could be a modern guy because of just the craziness right now.
So let's talk about that for just a second, because Jedi Knowles dropped in that it was actually over $200,000 for that Fernando Tatis, which was the red refractor numbered to 5. Well, doing the math on that and extrapolating it, wasn't the red refractor Trout like not
900,000? Wasn't that 900? Yeah, 900,000.
So that would put a Tatis super refractor at maybe $400,000 or $500,000 if we assume the same multiplier. So probably maybe still a little work to go. But can you imagine if over the next 18 months, if Tatis continues to kill it this year and kills it next year, what could the one-of-one autograph super refractor from Bowman be worth? Could that be a $1 million card?
Yeah, I have a sneaking suspicion we're not going to have long to wait. There are a couple high-profile auctions still to take place this summer, and there are a couple of top-quality products coming out very soon, including Bowman Chrome. So who knows?
Has there been a $1 million card in any other the LeBron James.
Yeah.
But is that the only $1 million basketball card we've seen?
No, I think I'd have to double check. I think there's been a Lou Alcindor over, but I'd have to double check that.
Wow. Well, crazy, crazy.
Yeah, so. It is crazy. So
good for them. I had a flip this week that was completely unexpected because you know how packages just sit here, Rob? I bought from Beckett Marketplace of all places. I bought a lot, paid $135 for like 150 cards or something from a shop on there May 6th. Did not open it. Had it sitting here unopened and knew what it was but forgot what was in it. There was a Luka Modric silver prism from 2014. Modric, not Doncic. Modric, Croatian football player.
Soccer player?
Listed it for $350. The last one it sold for $200, and it sold like that.
Don't you dare turn into one of those pretentious people that lives in the United States and calls soccer football.
It's not pretentious at all. It's actually
entirely pretentious.
It's the opposite of pretentious. It's kowtowing to the masses and the actual populism.
Yeah, you're still an American, and you know what football means in this country.
Yeah, it means spectacle and low card prices.
Don't go there. Don't even go there. Football.
They actually use their feet to kick the ball in that sport.
Oh,
explain to me why American football is called football. Well, I would never call soccer the gridiron, in all fairness. What if I said football? Would that make you feel better?
That made me feel a little bit better.
Did it make you vomit a little too?
Yeah, a little bit.
All right.
Just in my mouth.
At least we can be honest with each other.
All right. Well, like I mentioned at the top of the hour, we've got a lot to dive into in this week's hobby happenings. And much thanks to the people that answered my call for some artwork for this first slide. Here's a look at this week's hobby happenings. Move over, Honus. There's a new sheriff in town. The 2009 Bowman Chrome Prospect Superfractor autograph of Mike Trout, if you've been living in a hole, sold at Golden Auctions this past weekend for a staggering $3.93 million, which included the buyer's premium and fees. The sale unseated the T206 Honus Wagner card, which for literally decades had held the title as the most expensive sports card in the hobby. Whether it was the controversial example once owned by Wayne Gretzky or the one sold by Golden Auctions in 2016 for a world record $3.12 million, the venerable Wagner has a storied place in the hobby. Fast forward to 2018 when Dave Oencia, a.k.a. Vegas Dave, bought the Trout Superfractor for what was considered the ridiculous amount at the time of $400,000. And you might remember that Dave's haters came out in force ridiculing his purchase decision and him personally. However, as we speculated a few weeks ago, Oencia is having the last laugh and quickly took to Twitter after the card's sale. So in about 24 months, Oencia performed the hobby flip of a lifetime, realizing a profit of over $3.4 million. Incredible. Ken Golden spoke with Varney and Company on Fox Business about the sale. Watch this.
Yo, the Mike Trout baseball card on your screen. It sold for $3.9 million. Huge number. And look who's here. The man who auctioned it off, Ken Golden, founder of Golden Auctions. Ken, you weren't expecting to get nearly $4 million for it, were you?
I believe when I was on your show a few weeks ago, I said we were hoping it it broke the record of Honus Wagner, which was $3.1 million. Anything above $3.1 million, I would have been thrilled with. When you talk $4 million for a baseball card produced in 2009, which is right here, it's how can you not be thrilled with the price?
You see, I can understand how a Honus Wagner card from 100 years ago would be worth a great deal of money. But this is a brand new card. Okay, it's autographed, but it's a brand new card. Does this set off an explosion in baseball card values?
It has. I mean, it really has been starting over the past couple of years, but You know, the key with this card, it's a one of one. So it's like they only made one special Mike Trout rookie, and it was like the golden ticket that was randomly inserted. But this is really what's happening. It's systematic of my business. You know, a month ago, I was on your show talking about a record LeBron James card that ended up selling for $1.8 million, and that was the highest modern card. Now we've got a Mike Trout card produced in 2009, and that sold for close to $4 million. That's the most valuable baseball card of all time. What has happened is a ton of money is coming into the sports trading card market for alternate investing, collectors, and things like that, and the market is really not prepared for it because there's a limited number of high-value, key, elite products, and the demand for that product is far outstripping the supply, and I think it's going to be tilted, you know, as a really as a seller's market for the next 3-4 years.
The seller of the Mike Trout card, did that person originally buy it as an investment? And can you tell us what they bought it for?
Yes, I can tell you that individual purchased the card in 2018 for $400,000.
Wow, very smart.
And it's like you're buying a, you know, like a Zoom stock or something.
Not that good. Was the buyer a person or institution?
The buyer was an individual.
Wow, out of sight. Ken, thank you very much for bringing us all this great stuff over the years. We really appreciate it, and you hit the jackpot with that one.
In other, albeit less extravagant, auction news, Sports Collectors Daily reports that the highest graded autographed example of the 1984-85 Star Company Michael Jordan True Rookie card is on the auction block. Carrying a card grade of 9 and an autograph grade of 10 from Beckett, it's expected to sell for $100,000 or more when Heritage Auctions wraps up its current catalog sale. Only 3 Star Company Jordan cards have ever been given a higher grade. None of those 3 has the autograph, however. And as a follow-up to our conversation about the current hoarding and pillaging situation currently taking place at many major realtors around the country, one collector witnessed this sign and tweeted after talking to the vendor rep, allegedly, "Local Walmart baseball card vendor put this up." She said she was tired of being stalked and harassed by grown men over cards. Said same group follows her to each store. Even if she ropes off merchandise, they go over rope and fight over cards. While we discuss numerous potential solutions to the problem, this probably isn't one of them, and that all it does is pass the buck and makes it someone else's problem.
Just a quick caveat to that. I posted something this week with a sign at a Target that I saw that they did something similar, but they added that they were limiting purchases to 2 per customer of an identical item. So the combination of putting them somewhere else and limiting them is at least an additional step. So out of curiosity, I asked to see what was available, and there was really still nothing available. Well, some good news for leaf collectors, as it turns out. Late last week, the company tweeted that all outstanding Wander Franco autograph cards have been returned in-house and redemptions are starting to be fulfilled. So expect yours to arrive soon. And in another follow-up to a story we discussed last week, Golden Auctions has decided to actually pull the Michael Strahan jersey from its auction. Despite overwhelming photo evidence, quote, "It is indeed the one that he wore in the Super Bowl upset over New England back in 2008, quote.
Rob, I have some super exciting news. Tops is making football cards. That's right.
You.
For the first time ever, collectors can find the brightest young MLS stars on Bowman branded cards. 2020 Bowman MLS includes 80 of the top under 23 players in the North American League, Major League Soccer, along with 20 superstar veterans, and features photography from the recent MLS Is Back tournament. Collectors will be able to discover randomly inserted parallels as well as autographs. 10 card packs of the Bowman MLS 2020 cards cost $10 on tops.com. Watch this video.
America honored what would have been NBA legend Kobe Bryant's 42nd birthday this week with a brief montage of moments spent with their longtime spokesman. Watch this.
Thank you. Here we are. First signing in the books. There it is. Kobe and Panini. That's how we do it.
Ha ha. Does that work?
Thanks again. Thanks for everything, man.
See that hologram right there? I mean, this Panini authentic. I mean, this is the real deal. You can't get this no place else. Player.
You know, the Panini sticker collection, I mean, I was right there in that wheelhouse, their marketing demographic, growing up. So, I certainly understand the obsession with the stickers.
Walking the game, leaving the game for the last time, I was just so overcome with joy and very thankful for everything that the organization has done for me and what the fans have done for me and how they've inspired me throughout the years. And just being happy to kind of give the golden armor the proper send-off it deserves. So, yeah, this was awesome.
On April 13th, 2016, a retiring Kobe Bryant authored the perfect farewell from the NBA with a 60-point performance for the ages in L.A. on a court adorned with both of his numbers 8 and 24 and delivering a Hollywood ending in front of the hometown fans. The final 2 points of Kobe's game and career came with 15 seconds left at the free throw line, just a few feet from the piece of hardwood bearing his number 8, placed there to honor the number he wore when his career began. After the game, Bryant said farewell, thanked the crowd, and signed the court. The number 24 emblazed on the court is on display in Los Angeles. The number 8 from the Staples Center floor, signed by Bryant and measuring 20 feet by 8 feet in 4 panels, now heads to Heritage Auctions. And in the spirit of his extensive philanthropic work, 10% of the sales proceeds will go to Mamba and Mambacita Sports Foundation.
Very powerful story there. We have some more details regarding the schedule and content for this week's Topps Digicon. Today covered Star Wars Card Trader and Kick. Tomorrow dives into Bunt, WWE Slam, and the digital GPK Garbage Pail Kids offering. The weekend schedule is going to include Marvel and Skate on Saturday, and Disney along with The Walking Dead on Sunday. Be sure to follow Topps Digital to learn more about specific presenters, programming, giveaways, and more for this awesome online event.
As we've documented here in Hobby Happenings, the explosive growth in the hobby has resulted in a massive amounts of unprecedented coverage by mainstream media. Now that coverage is taking on a new form with the Sports Card Minute radio segment. Sports Collectors Daily is reporting that well-known sports card and sneaker collector Scott Keeney, a.k.a. DJ Ski, is launching what is described as a high-energy one-minute update on the sports card market. The Monday through Friday shows will offer his insights on various trends, topics, and sales in the sports card market, all in about 1 minute. Produced by international radio programming company Benstown, the show is expected to be picked up by many of its numerous affiliates and be available soon on a station near you.
One of the things that many collectors overlook in the hobby is protecting their collection. Well, what does that mean? That means insurance. Most homeowners and renters policies only cover items at purchase price, not actual current market value, and even then require things such as a detailed inventory with receipts, not just screenshots, as well as have caps, limits per type of item. So all of that is often required just to make a small dent in recovering from things like flood or fire. Well, noticing this gap in the marketplace, Beckett has teamed up with Collectibles Insurance Services to provide collectors with a more comprehensive and simpler means of making sure that their collectibles are protected. Visit www.beckett.com/insurance to learn more and get a quote for your collection.
The small town of Stevens Point, Wisconsin has received an influx of media buzz surrounded by the recent sale of what is believed to be the last surviving case of 1986-87 Fleer basketball. Larry Fritsch Cards was the consigner, and they talked to a local news affiliate. Check it out.
Card store is still celebrating after auctioning off a box of basketball cards for $1.79 million. News Channel 7's Brennan Scarborough met with store employees to hear about the sale.
I'm here at Larry Fritsch Cards, a trading card company in Stevens Point that just celebrated their 50th year of operation in May. But more recently, they celebrated the sale of a lifetime.
It sold for $1.79 million.
Larry Fritsch Cards manager Jeremy Fritsch put a box of unopened basketball cards up for auction. And the reason why it did so well was there was an estimated 36 unopened cards of an NBA legend.
Fortunately, we had one remaining case of 86-87 Fleer, which is the Michael Jordan rookie card. It did very well.
Jeremy says that part of the hype comes from the Michael Jordan Last Dance documentary, and now their phone is ringing off the hook in search of those cards.
There were late 80s and early 90s boxes that you couldn't give away 5 years ago, and it's just crazy demand for something that's been out for 30 years.
The trading cards as a whole has skyrocketed in recent months. One theory,
people are staying home more and not going out and shopping and spending money that way. There's a bunch of different things that could be contributing to it.
Pandemic or not, Jeremy maintains the same mindset as his grandfather, who opened the store 50 years ago, helping collectors find the cards they want.
From him up till my dad and now to me, that's really the main goal, is to help out the collectors and get this stuff out there. And hopefully this case that we sold is going to a good home. I've heard that it's not going to get opened up, so it's going to stay just like it is, and it's just going to stay as a case.
Now, if you would like to make a purchase from Larry Fritsch Cards, like this near mint Ken Griffey Jr. card, or would like to know about one of their auctions, we'll have a link to them on our website at WSAW.com. But remember, if you don't get it first, there's no crying in baseball. Reporting in Stevens Point, Brennan Scarborough, News Channel 7.
In some absolutely shocking and surprising news, okay, no, not really. News is pretty simply that PSA continues to break revenue records. In its quarterly earnings call with investors this week, Collectors Universe, the parent company of PSA, reported record revenue for the fiscal year of 2020. The company reported annual revenues of $78.9 million. They say the numbers, quote, were driven by continued momentum in the company's card/autograph business, which delivered a quarterly revenue increase of $2 million and yearly increase of $7.3 million, a 27% growth rate for both periods, end quote. PSA's card and autograph business has achieved quarter-over-quarter revenue growth in 39 of the last 40 quarters.
That's unbelievable. And last but not least, Upper Deck announced that it's helping Tiger Woods' foundation, TGR, with a new sales initiative. Through September 8th, Upper Deck will donate 25% of all Tiger Woods authentic memorabilia purchases that are made through the specially marked TGR Foundation catalog or through upperdeckstore.com with the code TGR at checkout. The current collection also includes several tournament worn items, which is amazing. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings. A lot going on.
Oh yeah, a lot going on. Including football cards. So happy about that. But you know, Rob, so I did a little math during it because I heard you slip in there something along the lines of what an incredible flip, or the greatest flip of all time for Dave Owensia with that Trout. And mathematically, the flip that I talked about just before the break was significantly better. His flip was only an 8.5x. And that's not even counting taxes and other fees we may not know about. My Luka Modric flip was 279x. Top that.
Wow. Pretty impressive. Dave Valencia. Pretty impressive. I heard you choke up when you got to the figure of $100,000 for the star card. And it seemed to me like you had the similar reaction that I did. Like that figure seems really low right now.
Yeah, I mean,
right?
Call me crazy,
like,
but
yeah,
find
you were
me
like,
another
wait,
example.
Am I reading
like
that right? And you were. That was the pre-auction estimate. And I'm like, I don't know. In this market, that seems pretty low. So who knows? We'll find out soon enough. Also, a couple other quick things. Yeah. All right. So that last story about Tiger Woods tournament worn stuff, it's not like that's been readily available through Upper Deck, which, you know, has an exclusive with Tiger and has for a very long time. But this limited edition catalog or whatever for this event has some tournament worn and autographed polos. Pretty cool stuff. $49,000 though. Pretty hefty retail price.
Wow.
But I wouldn't be surprised if one or two sold. People, they still have Tiger Mania. And yeah, it'll be really interesting to see where that piece of Kobe Bryant flooring ends up. I really hope it's someplace public. Really hope it ends up in a public setting. So we'll have to keep our eyes on that. Anything else before we dive into box breaks, Ivan?
You know, it's funny because we're about to open up some Upper Deck cards, some hockey cards. And I was just thinking, you know, nobody's, maybe I'm crazy, but people aren't talking about hockey enough. And it's kind of crazy. You go look at some of these prices on these rookie cards. I accidentally listed a card tonight that sold way too fast. So I don't know. I'm excited to just jump into hockey and see what's going on.
We have highlights from the first product of the 2021 season in the form of Upper Deck MVP. I pre-broke this box for time purposes, so we're going to check out some of the highlights. But I'll tell you, it's one of the most fun $50 or less breaks in the hobby. And Upper Ducks does some great marketing with this product, including a look at some of the top carryover rookies with a definition of what a carryover rookie is. And that being players who were late call-ups with their on-ice debut, past specific dates. But in this case, we alluded to players who would be eligible for rookie cards based on all the craziness that went on with the stoppage and whatnot. So a pretty really well done piece here that looks at some of the top rookies like Gabe Vilardi, Jason Robertson of the Stars, Josh Norris, Liam Foudy for the Columbus Blue Jackets. Keep an eye on him. He's also this week's Future Watch player profile. Still in the playoffs, Martin Kaut for the Colorado Avalanche, and more: Tyler Benson, Brandon Hagel, Kiefer Bellows, Jake Evans for your Kings, Mikey Anderson, and Morgan Geeky.
That's a pretty cool little guide there.
Yeah, really cool. And it comes one per box. All right, so let's check out highlights from MVP.
So remember, if you're opening a box of this as well, go to gogts.net and you can download the checklist,
which I found very helpful in opening this product, and I'll show you why as we go along.
Yeah, so, I like to have a little guide there because, you know, odds and things like that, and I never know what I'm looking at. As much as I do the show and as much as I tweet about the hobby, I still never know what I'm looking at. Though I do know Kaapo Kakko, isn't that a good rookie to pull?
Yeah. And
or is this a rookie, or is it
no longer rookie? The first three cards I'm showing you are base cards, but three fantastic sophomores in Nick Suzuki, Jack Hughes, and Kaapo Kakko. Okay, so that's the base design. Kaapo Kakko, yeah.
Now, I don't know. What are you doing switching to my pronunciation? It's literally a coin flip if I'm saying it.
Now, there are high series SPs. So you see the color pattern changes on the high series SPs.
Ooh, is that an autograph?
No. Oh. Here's Elias Pettersson.
Oh, it says MVP. It's a little blurry on the
Skype.
The thing that I'm looking at.
All right. And now Jonathan Toews is also one of the high series base.
Now I can read it.
And
I had to put on my glasses.
Claude Giroux. And Leon Draisaitl. I believe there's 50 high series SP veterans. But then you get some high series SP rookies like Jake Evans, Alexander True, Jason Robertson, like we saw in the guide.
Gosh, I feel like if you were passionate about hockey, it would be so, so easy to like go deep on prospecting with guys.
Oh, yeah. Yanni Hakapana, Alexander Yelsin, and Andre Chibasov were our rookies. Now, there are puzzle back variants to the base set that also serve as parallels, and they're designated by this kind of what would normally be on the back of the card, right there in the middle of the front of the card. So Dylan Strom, Ryan Strom, Andrei Savchenkov, Alex Ovechkin, and Sam Reinhart were our puzzle back variation parallels. Now, silver script parallels, where there is the facsimile autographed in silver script, Jake Muzzin, Cam Fowler, Danny DeKeyser, Carter Hart, Keith Yandel, Steven Stamkos. But then in addition to the silver script parallels, there are gold border silver script parallels numbered to just 100, and we pulled one of those of Matthew Tkachuk for the Calgary Flames. Pretty cool. However, the parallels continue with the gold script, and we found Carter Hart, Victor Arvidsson.
I hear the goalies are hot.
They are. Mitch Marner.
I forget that when I'm pricing my ComC cards, but.
And John Carlson. And a ton of great inserts. Look at this beautiful design for Mirror Mirror with Nikita Kucherov, Connor McDavid, Braden Point, high speed horizontal insert, and then another horizontal insert.
Oh, wait, not just horizontal, hologram, right? Is that some hologram action in the background on that?
Rainbow foil, yeah, absolutely.
Is it just rainbow foil or is it a hologram?
It's rainbow foil.
I want to call it a hologram.
And then I like this insert a lot, this close angle. Net Crashers, Johnny Gaudreau, MVP. And then returning once again and numbered to 250, Colors and Contours, Matthew Barzal. These are die cut, red script, facsimile autograph, as well as Ryan Nugent Hopkins. So what we're going to do is we are going to get all of these cards you just saw in the hands of one lucky winner.
Awesome. So Upper Deck MVP hits are all going to one place. That's pretty freaking cool. I just finished grabbing screenshots of all of that because it was my first time seeing it too. So give me 2 seconds, but make sure that you are checking in, hitting refresh on twitter.com/goGTSLive to see when that tweet goes up. You have to retweet the tweet and follow us in order to enter to win, and be watching when we announce the winners at the end to claim your prize. Hey, Rob, they actually don't have to be in Twitter necessarily to do it, though, right?
No, if you're watching us via the GoGTS Live mobile app available for Android currently, you can do it right from there, because it's one of the options is to follow us and engage right there. This is that guide we talked about. I'm going to throw that in as well so you can learn better what to look for. Next up, we've got two brand new products. And I think, when does Black Football, is this a worldwide debut or did that drop today? Okay, so this broke today, so, and we've got a box of it. 2020 NFL Black Football. Look at that cute little, you want to talk about simplicity and design? That's one box. There's 12 of them in a case. Five cards, including one autographed patch card. And let's see, I'll tell you here in 1 second. One autographed patch card along with one additional autograph card, one memorabilia card, plus one base and one parallel in every box. Panini says that Black is loaded with new and improved content, more rookies, and more inserts than ever before. All right, well, let's find out for ourselves.
Black. So again, go GTS Live on Twitter. Go there, enter to win. And let's check this out.
All right. Our base card is rookie Keyshawn Vaughn. Keyshawn Vaughn. Our parallel is numbered to 99 of Drew Brees.
Do you have an indication of what color the parallel is? Because either way, that black foil looks great on it. But is that on all the cards, or is that?
I think that's on all the cards.
That looks good. I like it. Now, I'm really bad at design, so that actually probably means that it's ugly, but.
Okay, now,
let's get one of those futuristic emeralds.
Eno Benjamin, rookie auto, numbered to 199.
Ooh, I was tweeting about him just today. My dad likes him. So I sent my dad a card of him. It's really blurry for some. Can you hold it back from the camera just a little further? Like, I feel like it's just too close to focus.
Like, I think you're too close to focus. What I'm physically looking at is crystal clear.
My face and your face are crystal clear, but what I'm seeing with the card is pretty. There we go. Yeah, that made a huge difference. Thank you.
This next card is huge. Number 25, four-color patch of Justin Herbert, numbered to just 25, part of the futuristic insert set.
Wow, that was that futuristic emeralds that I was just saying I wanted to see us pull.
Well, there you go. It's absolutely beautiful.
Wow.
But this next card is an absolute boom. Even though it's a redemption, our rookie patch autograph is none other than Chase Claypool.
Chase Claypool?
Yeah.
Who's that?
Oh, gosh, Ivan. You really need to start watching some college football. One of the most talented wide receivers in the draft coming out of Notre Dame.
Oh, I get why. Yeah, there you go. Notre Dame, that's why. We got the homer pick here. Notre Dame. That said, he is, was a second-round pick, went to the Pittsburgh Steelers. I feel like they skipped him for the instant, the draft set. That's why I don't know who he is.
All right.
I get all my information from checklists.
From the RPA, the additional auto of Eno Benjamin, and that beautiful emerald green number to 25 four-color patch at Justin Herbert.
Yeah, I love that, especially with the San Diego Chargers patch colors and picture on there. Very cool card. And then Chase Claypool. Well, here's the thing about Chase Claypool. Either way you slice it, he's a Notre Dame guy and he's a Steelers guy. I don't know. Two more rabid fan bases. Put those together. That's guaranteed to be popular. So,
next up, we got a big surprise for you guys. Big surprise in the form of 2020 Panini Immaculate Baseball. Immaculate Collection.
Ooh. Is
huge. Always delivers fun. High-end product. Current market price on release is $400 or more. And if you can find it less in the small window that it releases, scoop it up because it will go up quickly. So thank you to Tracy Hackler with hooking us up with some Immaculate Baseball cards. Every box, what, four autos, two memorabilia cards, Ivan? Is that right?
Sounds right. I'm still on Twitter. I'm actually tweeting. I'm not just playing. But it sounds right. It's loading. Six packs, six cards, four autographs, two memorabilia cards with unique materials like acetate, tweed weave, carbon stickers, and much, much, much more.
All right.
Sorry, this is the problem with the high-end products is they go so fast that I can't get the logistics down fast enough. Because I want y'all to see these incredible cards from the last break.
My kids were just asking me about another tin. We need another tin. I got too much little stuff I need to put in a tin.
There we go. All right. So, yeah, so some of the really cool things in here, jumbos with oversized material swatches from sweatshirts, batting gloves, socks, and many other game day player essentials. The monochrome set with the signed piece of eye black from the rookie class this year. Tribute cards to celebrate milestones. Jumbo nameplate, fielding glove, and batting glove pieces. And a checklist with some great veterans as well, such as Ken Griffey Jr. autographs. Not just the rookies that we're chasing here.
So. All right, let's dive right in. Off the top of the pack, we've got a Jack Flaherty jersey swatch, numbered to just 49 for the St. Louis Cardinals.
Lots of cardinal red on that.
Going
parallel of the team color. Gotta love it.
Going old school with Leo DeRocher game used material numbered to 99. And what kind of material is that? It designates him as a manager. What's that say? What does that say? It says, the enclosed game worn or used material guaranteed by Panini America. Like a little more info on a player that old. That's sweet. Leo DeRocher? All right, where were we at? All right.
We're at the autographs.
How about one of them eye blacky card things? This one of Trace Barea, or Barrera, numbered to just 25. Patch eye black auto on, that's called monochrome insert, number to just 25.
Very cool.
So that's a piece of eye black silver paint pen signature, three-color patch. Very cool. Wow, how about a little hats off from Joey Bart, number to 25.
Whoa.
Dual game used. Joey Bart. Boom!
Joey Bart, who got called up, what, last week and has been doing pretty freaking well. Collectors have been high on him for a long time. Number to just 25. If you're watching right now, tweet that out. Let your friends know they're not going to want to miss this.
How about a Ryan Mountcastle quad auto from the extra bases insert set, numbered to just 10.
Wow.
Three patches and a bat swatch.
Guy whose name's been thrown around quite a bit for possibly getting called up, if I'm up to date on my news.
And then we've got a jumbo patch auto, numbered to 66, of Randy Arozarena for the St. Louis Cardinals. Numbered to just 66, which is his jersey number.
Correction on Mountcastle. He did get called up 5 days ago. He just plays for the Orioles, so no one's heard about it. And apparently, article in the Baltimore Sun today say that his plate approach has paid off. I don't know what that means.
So we're going to go ahead and let's see.
That's pretty cool.
The two single swatches of Jack Flaherty and Leo DeRocher, I'm going to double up for one winner. And then the rest all single. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 winners. Ryan Mountcastle, extra bases, quad auto, number to 10. Joey Bart, dual auto, number to 25. Randy Arozarena, number to 66. The jumbo patch on card auto. The Tres Barrera, eye black, auto patch, number to 25, and the two single memorabilia cards. Thank you, Tracy. The sweet hookup. Tell them what they got to do, Ivan.
You've got to go to twitter.com/goGTSLive and retweet and watch live when we announce the winners at the end of the show. That's how you'll enter to win, and you've got a pretty strong chance of winning something with all that we're giving away. You also must be following us. Just a heads up, the randomizer program does require a follow in order for it to pull your name, so make sure that you are following GoGTS Live on Twitter.
Updating our poll question: Mantle, Wagner, Trout are the only baseball players to have cards sell for more than $1 million. Which baseball player will be next? And still leading with 72.8% of the vote, Babe Ruth and Joe Jackson. The vote total has absolutely swelled, though, to almost 400 votes, still 55 minutes left. Eddie Plank and Sherry Maggie getting a little bit more love, so we must have some vintage aficionados watching. And some of the replies for modern players as others, a lot of love for Fernando Tatis Jr. All right. As mentioned, we have an off the post segment provided to you by our very own Russ Cohen from 2019 NHL Rookie of the Year winner Elias Pettersson. Down 1-0 in the second round of the NHL playoffs against the Las Vegas Golden Knights, Vancouver Canucks star Elias Pettersson had something to say, and based on the results of the game, a 5-2 win, in which he had a goal and two assists, he and the Canucks responded. Now, at the age of just still 21 years old, this star has already 16 points in 12 playoff games so far. In this video, he talks to the media after the last game. Watch this, and we'll be right back.
Maybe we start with Petey, but there's certainly a lot of discussion coming out of game one about just a lack of offense from the top two lines. They've got a pretty good shutdown pair that you guys saw quite a bit of. with Schmidt. Just how do you battle through that, and how much pressure is there on you guys to drive offense?
First off, they're a good team. And second, we didn't play our best hockey. And today we got to bring it because, like I said, they're a good team. So we talked about it, looked on video, see what we can do better, and hopefully we play a much better game tonight.
Thanks, Russ Cohen. All right, here's a look at next week's new releases, sure to be hot in the shop or at your favorite online retailer or breaker. New products hitting stores next week starts with, I know Ivan's a big fan, 2020 mm-hmm. Top Stadium Club baseball cards. In fact, Ivan, why don't you take this one?
Oh, well, that's very special of you, especially if you saw my faux pas on Twitter earlier this week where I jumped the gun on the show and said, man, when is Stadium Club coming out? Well, guess what? It's coming out this week. That's right. So all the great photography, high gloss, high action imagery the set's been known for decades, combined with all new on-card autographs, two autograph cards per box, as well as one oversized box topper, one base card chrome variation. So keep your eyes peeled. Sort of a preview probably of that Top Stadium Club chrome that we're hearing about coming later in the year, as well as seven insert cards in every box. Now, of course, you're chasing hot rookie autographs. You know, we all know that we want Luis Robert, right? That's what we're after. But look at some of these other great, great images that are in this product. Really exciting imagery inserts, like those bash and burn inserts. Base autograph cards of some great veteran players, as well as young stars, up-and-comers. I always love just the variations, the black and white parallel cards, the various rainbows. And look at that co-signers card, numbered to just 10 with names like Mike Trout and Christian Yelich. So lots to chase and lots to collect in this product. Makes it a great win with baseball card collectors every year. Really excited for Top Stadium Club this year.
And next up, we have another baseball card product. This is a very unique offering from Historic Autographs called Half Century. Known for their cut signature baseball card products, this set's going to deliver eight original vintage baseball cards paired with a cut signature, including one Hall of Famer guaranteed in every box. So, yes, you are getting eight vintage cards, eight cut signatures, and one of them's guaranteed to be a Hall of Famer. Also, there's some case guarantees we'll dive into in just a minute, but this product embodies what vintage collecting is really all about. It combines nearly every card series from 1909 to 1949, including T205, T206, T207, M116 Cracker Jacks, E120s, 21, 22s, your caramel cards, the V61s, strip card series, DeLong's, U.S. Caramel, all the Gaudi series, Diamond Stars, Batter Up, 1940 and 41 Play Ball, Tip Tops, Bread, 48 and 49 Bowman, the R346s, M&Ps, and Sewell Greats, and many more. Okay. What are the case guarantees? You're going to get guaranteed one Group A player. Okay, so there's six boxes a case. Pretty cool deal here. In this Group A players, yeah, Babe Ruth, Lou Gehrig, Ty Cobb, Honus Wagner, Walter Johnson, Nap Lajoie, Jackie Robinson, Satchel Paige, Eddie Collins, Jimmy Fox, Mel Ott, Rogers Hornsby, Tony Lazzari, Tris Speaker, or Roy Campanella. Or, so one of those, or two from this group of players. Mickey Cochran, Home Run Baker, Jim Bottingley, Kiki Kyler, Dizzy Dean, Joe DiMaggio, Hank Greenberg, Goose Gosselin, Lefty Grove, Harry Heilman, Chuck Klein, Connie Mack, Robert Marinville, Herb Pencock, Epit Rixie, Al Simmons, Pi Trainer, Dazzy Vance, Archie Vaughn, Paul Wehner, or Ted Williams. You can't lose. Eight original vintage baseball cards paired with a cut in every box. All Hall of Famer players appear a minimum of two times, with most appearing more than twice. And there's numerous rookie card examples as well. So the three eras of cards include Era 1, 1909 to 1930. Those appear one in three boxes. Era 2, 1932 to 1941, 4 to 6 cards in every box. And then Era 3, 1943 to 1949, 2 to 3 cards in every box. So I remembered 6 boxes in a case. There's only 105 total cases. I really wish we could get our hands on a box of this product, because it looks like, I mean, you want to talk about potential instant cornerstone vintage collection. This is it. This is what that type of product can do for you. So 2020 Historic Autographs Half Century next week.
I just wanted to tack on with that, Rob. Do you remember the name of the website or the book that talks about rare autographs? Like 2 or 3 years ago at the National, we had a gentleman on that was an expert in that and had, I think, published a book on like what are the rarest autographs.
Ron Kajarian, Baseball Hall of Fame Autograph Reference Guide, who goes into a tremendous amount of detail about that as well.
Because this does reflect back, I know we've got a show to do, but this reflects back on the original poll question and things like that, Sherry McGee. Some of those names are really rare, even if you may not recognize them. And so if you love the hobby, or if you're new to the hobby and want to find a unique sort of niche, that really something to dive into is go to gogts.net and just look at that checklist and then start comparing that against either the PSA card autograph facts site or Ray, give us to us one more time.
Ray Kajarian's book, The Reference Guide to Hall of Fame Baseball Autographs.
Yeah. Can be a really fun rabbit hole for you to go down as a collector. So that said, there is still more that's hot in the shop. In a more traditional approach, we've got the gridiron. We've got football, 2020 Donruss NFL football cards. Each box is going to have 18 packs and going to deliver one autographed card and one memorabilia card, as well as 12 rookies, 6 rated rookies, and 12 parallels. So very exciting. Love just the traditional Donruss look with those rookies, with those uniforms. Cell sheet's a little old. It shows the Kyler Murray rated rookie. I hope he's not in this product as a rated rookie. That said, look at some of the incredible inserts that you're going to be able to find, whether it's things like Canton Kings with that beautiful, beautiful coloring on it, the Marvels inserts that have become so popular. One of my favorite Seeger songs, Night Moves, gets its own insert set. Check that out. And a 20-card set commemorating the 2019 Super Bowl champion Kansas City Chiefs with The Champ Is Here inserts. Look at that. That's got to be hot. New Inducted Holo, celebrating the Hall of Fame inductees this year, and Retro 2000 autographs, a throwback to the year 2000 on the Donruss design. Oh, and there's those Night Moves. Check that out. Of Michael Thomas, the greatest receiver in the league. Night Moves. I could sing that song for you right now. I'm not going to. Look for Donruss in stores on November 2nd, next Wednesday. Love it.
Or September 2nd, either or.
Is that what it's September?
These next two products we detailed for you last week. They got pushed back a week. In the case of our last product, we hope it's the last pushback. But for now, we're going to look at 2020 Panini Immaculate Collegiate football cards, delivering the best of the NCAA. You're getting 5 autos or memorabilia cards plus a base or parallel in every box. By combining premium patches, legendary autos, and a strong 2020 NFL draft class, Panini thinks this has the potential to be one of the best immaculate collegiate products in history. Woo! Lofty praise. Some of the autograph and memorabilia sets to look for are obviously rookie patch autographs and a variety of parallels as well, and immaculate jumbo team logos. Very special. What's more, you might find trio autographs, wrong with that? Nothing. And then some quad materials of the prime variety. Quad tags, they call that. And then you got your team slogan signature die cuts. It's a 50 card set. And then obviously premium patch rookie autos, jumbo memorabilia cards, including super premium like the Swoosh 25 card base set numbered to 99, and then parallels and from 49 all the way down to 101 in stores next week. Push back just 1 week.
Rob, I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it again.
Fair enough. 2020 Leaf Valiant football cards. We've been telling you about this, it seems, for like 5 weeks now. Hopefully it'll be here. And that's a look at the what's going to be hot in the shop. I don't blame you, Ivan. It's really crazy. Just put TBD and let us know like once and reschedule once, right?
Well, yeah. I mean, here's the thing. I do get it. And again, in Leaf's defense, you know, news like, hey, all the Wander Franco redemptions are in now for the product they mentioned.
Yeah,
you know,
but
like,
no.
They do a good job. But it was just, I saw it. And I just,
I know. You're going to get 8 autographs. They're all signed on card. Plus, you're getting a graded autograph card in every box. And the only BGS grades you're going to find, yeah, BGS 9.5, BGS 10, or BGS 10 Black Label. So chances are that the grading probably, we'll blame Beckett. I know, I don't want to blame anybody. I don't know why it's been delayed so often, but we can keep our fingers crossed because collectors love this. I mean, the chance to pop a graded card from a box that's already a 9.5 or better.
10 Black Label? Come on.
It's awesome. So
yeah. Hopefully. So again, I kid, but you can tell I'm actually excited for it. That's part of why I'm aggravated, is I want to start seeing this.
I know. So. I hear you. All right, we're going to put Ivan to work to pull tonight's winners. Brad Galley, who does a great job up in the Detroit area covering sports, also periodically reports on the sports card market. And he has a lot to say with a visit to a card shop in his area and a report that was broadcast during the news this past week. Check this out, and we'll be back to announce tonight's winners.
All right, having fun and making some money.
We're talking about the sports card industry exploding during the pandemic. Sales of a Mike Trout rookie card, baseball card, for $900,000. And how about a LeBron James rookie card at $1.8 million? It has collectors across the country paying serious attention.
That includes our in-house card collector and sports director, Brad Galley.
Tonight he explores why the industry boomed and how it's having an effect here in Metro Detroit.
One of the first questions people who are unfamiliar with sports card collecting usually ask, do you still get a piece of bubble gum when you open a pack? Those days are gone, but the nostalgia that created for generations of collectors remains. It just comes in the form of an autograph or memorabilia, and the potential value has skyrocketed through this pandemic. When the sports world stopped, collectors dusted off their collections, and they're trying to invest in the next big thing.
It's almost like you're betting on who you think's going to be good, you know, a couple years down the road. It's like trading stocks.
Card collecting has been a part of sports for a century.
I was looking to get a few autographs because I'm trying to get my first autograph.
Countless collectors looked for something to keep them close to the game they loved, to recapture some of that youthful passion for sports. In doing so, collectors found big investments.
How wild have these last few months been for you?
It's been a little crazy.
Steve Makowski is the owner of Rochester Sports Cards and Memorabilia. Throughout the last few months, he's barely been able to keep his shelves stocked.
I think a lot of people started going through their old collections again and looking at stuff and then starting to do a little bit of research and realizing that the sports cards of today are a lot different than when they were in the 80s and 90s.
Upper Deck, Panini, and Topps have found innovative ways to create a new wave of value for collectors.
Topps has this unique position of being the bridge between the fans or the collectors and the game and the players. So people have really come to Topps over the past couple of months when we really haven't had any sports on our TVs.
Just like any industry, the card manufacturers had to either innovate or die. And that's when they started looking at putting autographs in the products, pieces of memorabilia, all of that really helped out you know, get collectors back into it.
I got a basketball hobby box like a month and a half ago for just over $400. And those same boxes right now are selling on eBay for $1,200 with no problem.
The reason? Everyone is looking for who's next. The LeBron James autograph memorabilia rookie card sold in July for $1.8 million. A Mike Trout autograph rookie card sold in May for $900,000.
It's insane. A Zion autograph is worth $10,000.
So if you pulled one of those out of that, what would your reaction be?
I mean, like I want a big game.
One local man did win that big game. Mason Caddy's family owned Sports Card City USA in Royal Oak for 21 years. He stopped collecting when his family sold the shop, but when he saw the hobby booming again, he jumped back in.
2019-20 Prism Zion Williamson Gold, number 1 of 10.
And you sold it for how much?
$15,000.
That's going towards his son's college fund. There's risk involved in spending on anything that comes without a guarantee, but the return on investment with cards has never been higher. That same bubblegum nostalgia, the tie to the youthful love for the game, it hits home for collectors who have rediscovered the love for cards.
So is there a guarantee to all of this? No, like a collector said, it's like the stock market, but the more you know and the more you put time into it, the better your odds may be. Collecting's fun after all, and it gets us closer to the games we love. In Rochester, Brad Galley, 7 Action Sports.
Man, very cool. I wish I had that LeBron card for $1.8 million. That was pretty sweet.
That's right. And, you know, old school is okay too, Carolyn. This is Al Kaline rookie card, 1954 Tops. It's one I have been searching for a long time and finally picked it up. It is a wonderful addition to my collection. It's just a piece of cardboard, right, with bright colors and pictures on it. But if it means something to you, then it's valuable, whether somebody else wants to pay for it or not. But the all-time great Mr. Tiger, Al Kaline, and his rookie cards now.
All right. So, yeah, hey, there's something you didn't know. The sports card market is hot. All right. We've got some winners, Ivan.
Yes, we do. Sorry, I just got distracted because Daryl Strawberry is trending on Twitter. And these days, who knows what's going on.
Was he arrested for coke?
He was spotted in the stands at the RNC for Donald Trump's speech. And that's enough to get you trending nowadays.
Wow.
So,
okay.
Yeah. So.
All right. We've got
Twitter trends. Always fun.
Let's see.
9. You better have 9 for me because I pulled 9 winners tonight, Rob. So if you don't have 9 cards, you're going to have to do some digging.
6, 7, 8. Yep, I got 9 winners here.
Okay. Well, cool, because I have 9 names of winners. But before we announce the winners, first off, thank you, everybody, for watching. Thank you for engaging. Make sure that you do follow and engage on Twitter. Go back. You still have time to at least comment on the poll question. Let us know your thoughts and engage throughout the week. We really appreciate it. Thank you to everybody on Twitch that subscribes. If you didn't know, if you have an Amazon Prime membership, you actually get a free Twitch subscription. And we make as much per subscription per month as it costs to ship half a card.
Basically.
So if you ever want anything from us that, 2 months of subscribing for free, paid for that. But yeah, so we do appreciate that though. Every drop helps, keeps the lights on. And if you hear your name at the end of the show right now, what we need from you in order to get your item to you, the subscription is not required, it helps. But to get your item to you, we do need 4 things. We need you to email us 4 things at gogtslive@gogts.net. The name of the show at the name of the website. Very easy. Email us your name, your Twitter handle, your mailing address, it's not magic, and what you won. Name, Twitter handle, mailing address, what you won. Help us pair it up nice and easy. By us, I mean my co-host Rob, who does so much freaking work. Make it easy on him. First person that needs to make it easy on him, it's winning all of the hits from that Upper Deck MVP box, the first new hockey product of 2020-21, is Cat931. Cat931. Hopefully that's a real person and not a cat that entered by accident. You might get a return request on that, Rob. But Cat931, congratulations on the Upper Deck MVP hits. Next up, going to Panini America Black. Ooh, loving it. The Eno Benjamin auto is going to Current A Fear. Fair? Fur. F-E-H-R. Current A Fear. Congratulations on the Eno Benjamin autograph from Panini Black. Next up, oh, I feel bad. They won football cards, not hockey cards. The Emerald Justin Herbert, numbered to just 25, is going to Hockey Fan 97. Well, sorry, hockey fan, you won some football cards, but I hope you enjoy it anyways. You can be fans of both, can't you? And then finally, that Chase Claypool RPA auto is going to our good friend Chris Brown 1. Chris Brown 1. Of all the Chris's that watch the show, of all the Chris Browns that watch the show, he's number one. Sorry, Chris Brown 2. So congratulations on that awesome hit. And next up, we are going to Immaculate Baseball. First off, we've got both of the patch cards from that. Both of the relic cards are going to somebody that's a fan of two teams, Met and Sox fan. Ah, I don't know if either of those are Met or Sox guys. I can't see. It's a little small. But hey, you won some more. Maybe you'll be a Cardinals and Yankees fan. Or, oh, wait, Tris Speaker, that's a Cubs card, isn't it?
Leo DeRocher, Brooklyn.
Oh, Leo DeRocher. He was a Cubs manager, though.
Yes, he was.
I knew there was a. I knew there was Cubs involved there. So next up, actually, sorry, now I'm fixating on that. Met and Sox fan probably means that they are not a Brooklyn fan or not a Cubs fan. Sorry. But hey, do with the cards, trade them. That's what the hobby's about. Rob's like, I want to get out of here. All right. So the Tris Barrera monochrome eye patch autograph number to 25 is going to Ricky Hedrick 23. Congratulations, Ricky Hedrick 23. The Joey Bart autograph, numbered to 25 with some relics, is going to the Peevemeister. Congratulations, Peevemeister. The Ryan Mountcastle autograph is going to Foxy Clean 23. Foxy Clean 23. So if there's one thing you can learn from tonight's show, it's that the randomizer likes people with numbers at the end of their name. And then finally, the Randy Arizona autograph, numbered to 66, is going to Rubiniz Racing. Rubiniz Racing. No numbers at the end there. Just a regular viewer. So, hey, great to see your name on the winner sheet. Great to see all of your names on the winner sheet. Great to see all of your comments in the Twitch chat. It's always appreciated. And on the Twitter. Keep those replies coming during the off days. Oh, and guess what? If you missed a little segment of the show tonight, or if you missed last week and want to catch up, you can see all the past episodes and clips on YouTube, youtube.com, search Go GTS Live.
And be sure to download the mobile app for the easiest access. Take us with you wherever you go. And yes, the Android is still in development. If you've ever developed an app for Apple, the process is very, very, very slow. A couple quick programming notes. Are you ready for this announcement, Ivan?
It depends. There's two super exciting programming notes tonight, so I don't know if I'm ready yet because I don't know which of the two it is, but I'm really excited.
We received a FedEx notification from Tops. That means
our Project 2020 card shipped?
Almost all likelihood, we are going to be receiving Tops product to preview again.
Ooh.
They had been shut down because of COVID. I used to get those on a regular basis from our friend Emily Kless. It's the first one I've gotten in months. So
you
very
know what's glossy and coming out next week, Rob?
I don't know what I know what's coming out, but I don't know what's in this package that's supposed to be delivered Saturday. So I can't wait. And then next up, we'll have special guest interview with DJ Kazmarak, VP of Sales for Panini America.
Yeah. In fact, I was going to tease a little bit. Remember, in our hobby happenings, we touched on retail hoarding, flipping, scrounging, whatever word you want to use. I have a feeling DJ is going to talk to us a little bit about that and some efforts that Panini is taking, because he's been actually pretty transparent in some conversations with collectors. So very excited to have him on the show. You will not want to miss that conversation if you like the hobby at all. Right?
Exactly. So thank you to Tracy Hackler and Chris Carlin for hooking us up with product to preview tonight. Thanks to James Gale behind the scene, as always, making us look good, keeping everything sounding good. And yeah, be sure to check out past episodes to keep you tied over. Be sure to check out the Wax Pack Heroes podcast with Michael Sumner. I did an interview with him that airs tomorrow. If you want to find out more about the business from a distributor standpoint, check that out. So we'll be back next week with a brand new episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. So for Ivan Lovgren, there he is. Love you, bro. And James Gale, I'm Rob Bertrand. We'll be back next week with a brand new episode. Thank you for watching, and have a good weekend. We'll see you soon.